Hello all, myself Janil. Let us discuss bearing capacity. This is third lecture for bearing capacity. In previous two lectures, in first lecture we have discussed basics of bearing capacity like definitions etc. and in second lecture we have discussed in depth Terzaghi's theory, right, as well as its numericals. In this lecture we are going to learn IS code method. Let us move towards IS code method to find bearing capacity of soil. What is the capacity to take load? Let us move forward. IS code method for general shear failure. Here IS 6403 1981 is named as code of practice for determination of bearing capacity of shallow foundation. Here the formula is given in the IS code already given by Indian standards. This is QNU for net ultimate bearing capacity, which is C into NC, SC, DC, IC plus Q, NQ minus 1, SQ, DQ, IQ plus 0.5 gamma B, N gamma, S gamma, D gamma, I gamma into W dash. Now, this long formula is very simple if you understand that here. QNU, that is net ultimate bearing capacity, SC, SQ and S gamma are shape factors, same way DC, DQ, D gamma are depth factors, and IC, IQ, I gamma are inclination factors, as well as NC, NQ and gamma are bearing capacity factors which are given by Vesic. Vesic is the name of researcher. Q, that is effective pressure, right, as we understand at the base. So this is basis of IS code and this is most basic formula for general shear failure. For local and all we will understand in more depth, but first of all let us start one factor by one factor. Let us understand that. Now the factor W dash takes into account the effect of water table. If the water table is at or below a depth of D plus B measured from the ground, is if at the depth of base or below the depth of the base, you have to take W dash as 1.0. But if the water table is likely to rise to the base of the footing or above the value of W dash, it should be taken as 0.5. And third option, if the water table is located at the depth DW below the ground surface such that D is lesser than dw and dw is lesser than d plus b, then the value of w should be interpolated, and for there is a formula given which is w dash is equal to 0.5 in bracket 1 plus zw2 by b, which is same as factor rw2 which we have studied in previous theory, which is Terzaghi's theory. Let us move forward. Shape factors like SC, SQ and S gamma. So for shape factors there are different values given in the IS code for different geometries of footing like stiff footing or continuous footing. SC, SQ and S gamma all are 1, right? Same way rectangular, there is a formula given 1 plus 0.2 b by l, so you need breadth and length in all the three formulas, as well as for square footing and circular footing there are fixed values like 1.3, 1.2 etc etc. So you have to remember this table, or whenever IS code is available with you, you do not have to remember this. Moving forward, depth factors. The depth factor DC, DQ, D gamma are given below. DC 1 plus 0.2 D by B, 1045 degrees plus 5 by 2. These are defined by IS code only. So we have to accurately go with these formulas only. So do not forget how to use them and where to use them. DQ is equal to D gamma is equal to 1.0 for one and one case only, which is phi is less than 10 degrees. DQ is equal to D gamma is equal to something, formula is given when the phi is greater than 10 degrees, right? So here there are two options, if phi is less than 10 degrees as well as if phi is greater than 10 degrees. Moving forward to inclination factors. Now IC, IQ both are taken as an equivalent of 1 minus alpha upon 90, both are taken in degrees whole square. Here I gamma will be 1 minus alpha upon phi whole square, where alpha is what? Angle of inclination of the load with vertical. So if this is your vertical and this is inclination angle of load, then this is your alpha. So keep this in mind. Moving forward, now let us talk about local shear failure. So IS code has given one more formula for local shear failure. Q dash nu is equal to 2 by 3 C mc dash sc dc ic plus q nq dash minus 1 sq dq iq plus 0.5 gamma b n gamma dash s gamma d gamma I gamma w dash. Here n, s, d, I all are factors given by IS code only as well as w dash. So here the change will be minor, which is in phi dash. So phi should be taken as phi dash, and phi dash will be 10 inverse 2/3 of 10 phi. So whenever you are putting phi, you have to put phi dash. Here IS code gives one more table for NC, NQ and gamma values, as Terzaghi has defined some basic ideas like that. IS code also gives some table and some values of these constants. So you can find it here. For 0 degrees, NC is 5.14, NQ is 1 and N gamma is 0. Moving forward to problems. So problem 2 states that a strip footing of 2 meter width is placed at a depth of 4 meter below ground surface. So basically that is a strip footing which is having width 2 meter and depth 4 meter. Determine the net ultimate bearing capacity using Terzaghi's equation and IS code. So we have to use both these things, one Terzaghi's equation and second IS code. For Terzaghi's equation, we have to understand previous video, and IS code this video. Let us understand. Unit weight of soil is 20 kN per meter cube and cohesion is 10 kN per meter square. Okay, so let us write given data first and then we will go to move to solution. B 2 meter, D 4 meter, C 10 kN per meter square and gamma 20 kN per meter cube. Let us write formulas for clay and Terzaghi's formula first. Here phi is 0, so NC, N phi, N gamma will be determined from phi value, right? So as phi is 0, NC 5.7, N phi 1.0, N gamma 0. Here in problems, sometimes they give these values otherwise. For phi 0, you have to remember these three values. Generally, it must be provided. Terzaghi's equation is like C into NC plus gamma D into NQ plus 0.5 gamma B into N gamma. Putting values of all the constants, I am getting QU as 137 kN per meter square. After that, I want to find out net ultimate, right? So I have to find out QNU. For QNU, it will be QU minus gamma into D. QU, I got that 137. Gamma is 20 and D is given as 4. So putting all values, Q and U comes out as 57 kN per meter square. Moving further to IS code method. In this, phi 0 degrees. So NC, N phi and gamma values are like 5.14, 1 and 0. We have to see it from table. So Q and U value from IS code directly will be C and C plus Q and Q minus 1 plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma. Putting NC, NQ and N gamma all values in this equation, I am getting Q and U as 51.4 kN per meter square. So we can see both the values of Q and U. Here Terzaghi's equation gives Q and U net ultimate bearing capacity as 57 kN per meter square, where here IS code method gives 51.4 kN per meter square. So you must go with lower strength, right? So you will be safe. Let us move Further to next problem, problem 3. Determine net allowable load and gross allowable load for a square footing of size 2 meter cross 2 meter and at 1 meter depth. Use Terzaghi's theory. Here we are told to use Terzaghi's theory. Gamma 18, C dash 15, phi dash 25, factor of safety 3, NC dash, NQ dash, and gamma dash are given. Here all are in dash. So you have to understand that it is a case of local shear failure. And phi is also directing the same, and phi is 25. It is lesser than 29. So it is a, again, local shear failure. For that, I will use QU is equal to 1.3 C dash and C dash plus gamma D and Q dash plus 0.4 gamma B and gamma dash. Here I am having values of C dash and all the constants. So I am putting values in this. So QU value comes out as 435 or 48 kilonewton per meter square. After that, I will find out QNU. Here, keep this in mind. What do you want to find out? I want to find out net allowable load as well as gross allowable load. So I will go through all the formulas and find out the ultimate aim of mine. Let us move to QNU. QNU is already known, that is QU minus gamma into D. I am putting gamma and D value as well as QU value. I am getting QNU as 417.48 kilonewton per meter square. After that, I will find out QNS. NS is what? Bearing capacity. NS. NS means net safe bearing capacity. So it will be QNU by factor of safety F. By dividing 3, I will get QNS as 139.16 kilonewton per meter square. After this, I will find out net allowable load. And after that, I will find out gross allowable load. So for net allowable load, I am having net safe load. Sorry, net safe capacity. From that, I want to find out load. So I will multiply it with area. Here, area is provided as 2 meter cross 2 meter. So I am multiplying it with 4. And I am getting 556.64 kilonewton net allowable load. For gross load, I have to add something. So let us do QS is equal to QNS plus gamma into D. Now, I am adding surcharge into this. That is how I will get gross allowable bearing capacity first, and then I will move to gross allowable load. So bearing capacity, which is safe and which is allowable but which is gross, comes out as 157.16 kilonewton per meter square, and gross allowable load comes out as, multiplying with area, I am getting total gross allowable load as 628.64 kilonewton. So that's it in this chapter. We will meet in next video with a new chapter. Thank you.